365.
We're here at the SharePoint Conference in Las Vegas with the amazing Naomi Moneypenny.
Viva Las Vegas!
Woohoo! Woohoo! We're here! And there's so much I can discuss with you.
I know.
I don't know where to start, but we're trying to get these videos short and brief and to the point. So can you tell our audience, what do you do with Microsoft Search? What have you been doing there? And how will Microsoft Search help people to get more work done in a pretty nice, funny, happy fashion?
Yes, absolutely. Making people happy, it's our first priority. So I often think about having a happy dance during search. So this is what I'm really striving for. Exactly,
that would be nice.
Exactly. This is exactly
the
what we want.
The happy search dance.
This is what
I'm
we need.
I'm going to remember that.
That's right. So what we're trying to do with Microsoft Search is really have one cohesive experience going across the suite. And so you've seen recently that we've started rolling out the same search header across all of your applications in Microsoft 365. So that's including Bing, it's including Office.com, SharePoint, it's inside of OneDrive, and now even inside of the desktop applications that you use every day, so like Word, PowerPoint, Excel. So that same search experience coming to all of the different endpoints that you have. And our focus is really on delivering you answers. What we don't want to do is deliver you just pages of blue links, right? Because that's really an old model, if you think about it, from like the consumer days of like, let me just give you pages and pages and pages of results. Mm-hmm. That's not helpful. You want an answer because you're trying to get your work done,
yeah.
Right?
So, quick, crisp answers on
exactly,
what you're looking for.
Exactly. So what we've done is done things like location search, people search. I can put in the name of a building, for example, on campus, and I get a map of that building. I get directions on how to get there. I get people's profiles, and I can see whether they have calendar availability. I can check out what organization structure they're in and be able to explore all of that information right there. I can even see inside of conversations in Teams and Yammer as well. So being able to bring all of that knowledge in one place so you can get to the answer you need quickly.
I saw it's called answer cards, right?
Mm-hmm.
In your result, you
exactly.
can have like a top, the thing at the top,
exactly.
which has directly the answer you might be looking for.
That's right. And you can curate those for your organization. So that's another way to think about that productivity saving. So mm-hmm. if you're an admin, you can actually go ahead and curate an answer for your company. And so if there's something people search for all the time, you're able to put that and pin that experience basically to the top. And then you have it everywhere, whether you do that search in Bing, you do it in Office, you do it in Windows, it'll be there everywhere.
That's so powerful.
It is.
And it's going to save so many people so much time. It's
exactly.
People are really going to be happy about that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we should like add to the answer cards. I have a feature suggestion now.
Sure.
I want to have animated GIFs in my answer cards.
Oh my goodness,
so,
wow.
Like a dancing guy when you get your happy answer.
That's right. Maybe we'll have a feedback mechanism in there. How's that?
That would be nice. So if you would have to name like a particular use case that you mm-hmm. want to point out where people have like as a productivity hack
sure.
could get their work done quicker, what use case would you mention? Is there
sure.
another one that you would like to share?
Yeah, absolutely. I think this is one that's more visionary, and it's probably a good example to be able to share. So we're actually looking at how you create tasks directly inside of when you're working in an application. So for example, if you're laying out a document in Word, oftentimes we found that people actually will write little placeholders in the document, right? So mm-hmm. you say, hey, insert, you know, in the introduction in here, and then you write some text, and then you go off and find other things that you have to do. And so you'll often there actually write a command to yourself to say, you know, insert the sales revenue results for 2019. And so what we're doing with Microsoft Search is actually proactively turning those kinds of tasks into commands that we send back to Microsoft Search to go source that data.
Mm-hmm.
So you may be familiar right now inside of Word and PowerPoint, we showed it in the keynote yesterday, you can already go off and discover new content and then insert that content directly inside of Word. The sort of the advancement we're making on top of this, in order to make you happy, that's most important, we want to do that. We want to be able to take those little internal tasks that you might write for yourself and then be able to translate that into a search suggestion directly inside of where you're working. And so the difference is we're having Microsoft Search be proactive and actually offer you assistance directly where you're working and then suggest the information that could be most useful for you to reuse inside of your document so you get your job done faster.
That's amazing. It's like basically a lot of people do this, of course.
Exactly.
And now you're doing that and automatically this stuff is being done for you.
Mm-hmm.
Like that Microsoft Search is then being your personal assistant
exactly.
getting the data for you.
Exactly.
And while we're doing feature requests, I can imagine like it's like the note to self, mm-hmm. where if you write it,
yes.
it already it's like note to assistant actually
exactly.
that you're doing.
Exactly, that's right.
I can imagine that within the Outlook environment, that will mm-hmm. also be very useful.
Exactly, exactly. Across all of those services we have, we think about it as a canvas, if you will, inside of Office. Mm-hmm. And so we want that proactivity and that assistance to help enable you to get whatever you're creating done faster. And so we think about search suggestions. We think all of us about your developers yourselves inside of your organization. So right now we're thinking about search suggestions that are just based on all the data you have inside of Microsoft 365. But an obvious question is like, how do I extend this to other systems, right?
Yeah.
So if I have a line of business system, if I have a CRM system, how can I use that data too? And so that's one of the things we wanted to talk about is so from a keynote perspective is actually showcasing like this is the information that you have inside of those line of business systems, have a way for your organization's developers to plumb in, if you will, those search suggestions so that it can use that data directly again where you're creating the document.
That's cool. So just not so Microsoft Search is searching through OneNote and mm-hmm. SharePoint and OneDrive
exactly.
and Stream and
exactly.
Yammer and all those Office 365 mm-hmm. Content repositories basically where data can be stored
mm-hmm.
and you can extend it
yes.
with external applications.
Exactly.
And I heard that there might be some extensions coming out of the box
mm-hmm.
and which common use cases or common connectors basically towards certain
yeah.
third-party applications.
Yeah, that's right. So search suggestions are something that we think about from a Microsoft Graph connection more generally. So we'll have ways for your organization's developers to plumb in those search suggestions.
Mm-hmm.
With Microsoft Search overall, of course, we will definitely have Microsoft Graph connectors. And so we'll be able to talk to third-party systems automatically, as well as having a range of APIs and user-defined types that you'll be able to customize.
Amazing stuff. Mm-hmm. This is so much going to change our lives.
I'm really excited. It's, really excited.
Yeah. and it's going to bridge many gaps. Like. People have lose so much productivity in searching stuff, and like the figures you have, like 4 to 8% of the people are working on finding stuff or recreating stuff
exactly,
because
exactly.
they could not find it.
That's right. So
it's going to bring a lot of productivity.
Exactly.
For sure.
Yeah.
Really well,
excited.
Thank you very much for being here for this interview.
Mm-hmm. It's my pleasure, Martin. Always a pleasure to talk to you.
Likewise, and well, thank you, and see you next time.